So, in the last clip, I was getting somewhere with analyzing connections and influences in the YouTube religious identity survey. It stopped with me analyzing three different qualities together. And by doing that a lot of times, I kind of got this picture, where gender influences life after death belief, and where those two factors in turn influences everything else considered here. Getting to know the dependencies involving more than three different qualities meant that I had to put the whole set of different qualities into the analysis, and that would need a lot of work. I was ready to give up when I stumbled on a program called LearnBase when searching for something else. The program searches for an optimal probabilistic network for describing categorical data. The really great thing was that I could specify the same criterion for optimization as I used for my own analysis, and that I could specify where the network should begin. In my case, the ground or root influencer was assumed to be gender. Couldn't remove non-answers as I did for my previous analysis, but those were in a minority and could hardly be expected to create any dependencies of their own. So I put the data into the program. I tried different optimization strategies to make reasonably sure that the results I found could be assumed to be the best possible explanation of the data. And here's the result. As you can see, the three quality analysis I did on my own was right in putting life after death belief near to the root of the network, as a prime influencer to all but gender. As an aside to my viewers in the debating community, maybe belief in the afterlife is an issue that needs to be addressed more often. As in the previous analysis, supernatural experiences and religious identity follows after the question about belief in life after death. The next striking thing here is how central the religious identity is. It influences not only the obvious connection to reincarnation, creationism, evolution, abiogenesis, and stem cell research. Indirectly, it also influences belief in the Big Bang and the stance towards the age of the Earth and towards masturbation. Note that belief concerning evolution separates religious identity and stance towards the age of the Earth. Knowing a person's stance towards evolution will help you predict that person's stance towards the age of the Earth. In that case, no other factors are relevant. At least no other direct connections were found in this dataset. The same goes for creationism and masturbation. Non-creationist Christians were thus not detectably different from the rest in this regard. Also note that Big Bang belief is indirectly influenced by religious identity. The direct influence is evolution and abiogenesis. I'm guessing the model is picking up general interest in science. It's also interesting to see that condition on religious identity, belief in evolution won't help you predict a person's belief in abiogenesis and vice versa. That is, unless you also condition on belief in the Big Bang. I would interpret that as there being many people who believe in evolution but are not sufficiently interested in science to look at what abiogenesis is or the Big Bang theory. Just like in clip 3, I was also curious about the difference between atheists and agnostics. Removing all others, I found some of the same connections, though evolution, creationism, age of Earth, stem cells and stance towards masturbation was now detached from the model. Either atheists and agnostics are the same in those respects, or the data wasn't sufficient. However, we are left with the following connections. Gender affects life after death belief, which again influences belief in reincarnation. Reincarnation seems to be the main influence in the division between agnostics and atheists, though of course many agnostics do not believe in reincarnation and some atheists may. Supernatural experience now seems to be influenced by whether a person is an agnostic or atheist. Earlier it looked like supernatural experience was directly influenced by life after death belief, but for this subgroup of agnostics and atheists, It seems that this division is a better explanation. Also, that division seems to influence belief in abiogenesis and the Big Bang Theory. We could also divide the world into Christians and non-Christians, as some, though definitely not all, Christians may do. The picture is a bit altered, but the state of being a Christian is not exempt from being influenced. It may seem weird that creationism affects whether you're a Christian or not, but speaking from my past, I kind of understand it. Children in creationist environments may first be introduced to a religious explanation for the world, before being introduced to the finer points of the religion. Christians do not seem much separated from the rest here. Creationism seems in a greater degree to influence other beliefs, whether those in question are Christian or not. Only for reincarnation and stem cell research do Christians differ from others. Some of the orderings differed for different divisions of religious identity. This is not so strange. The further apart from the root of the probabilistic network we go, the less certain we can be about what influences what. Small imprecisions in the data can affect the outcome. Still, for all studies here, the question about belief in an afterlife seems a central influence upon the rest of the qualities. It seems only to be influenced by gender, and gender is assumed to be a genetic lottery, not influenced by anything else here. So it seems clear that a belief in an afterlife is a major influence upon people's general worldview. Religion is a secondary effect. Similarly, the opinion that one has had a supernatural experience is also influenced by other factors. Indeed, it looks like afterlife belief is the likely suspect here too. Big Bang belief seems to be influenced by both belief in evolution and abiogenesis. Whether you believe in evolution or not influences your stance towards the age of the Earth, it seems, and belief in evolution and abiogenesis is affected by religious factors, such as overall identity or possibly creationism. And stance towards creationism influences one's stance towards masturbation. Anyway, I hope you learned something today. I certainly have learned a lot doing this study.